Hi, this is Paul from Royal Oak Farm, and wanted to give everybody a quick update on where we are with our crops and some of the activities that are going on the farm right now. A lot of people are curious and wonder, hey, what's going on the farm as we're getting ready for the season here. As you can see from the trees behind me, these are Zestar, specific variety, and they're starting to size up. We're getting about a little bigger in golf ball size so far. These will ripen usually around the end of August, so they still have several weeks to go. And they'll start to size even more. The cells in the apple will continue to expand and get larger, and we'll start getting some color on them, and you'll start to see better sized apples by the time you get even into the beginning of August, middle of August. We've had really rough conditions at the farm here the last several weeks, previously with all the rain we've had. We're starting to get some dry weather now. We're going to start to be able to get out in the field, do some work and some other activities. One of the other things that's been occurring is because of all these wet events, the bees have not been able to fly as much as they normally would be able to, and we have quite a few hives that are still here on the farm right now. So we've had issues and concerns with being able to be out to check them and monitor them in these rain events, because they're actually doing more work inside the hive when they're not out foraging and gathering pollen and nectar. And a lot of times they can build out and run out of space very quickly in their hive if they're in there a lot. So we've had issues with swarming on a few of the hives that we had anticipated had a little bit more time before they'd be ready to swarm, and nope, they swarmed a lot quicker than they were supposed to. So we've been dealing with swarms. We've had two or three of them now from a few of our hives. So fortunately, we've been able to capture all of them, and we'll be able to have another colony out of that. But it does slow down our honey production as we get into the season, because you lose half the bees out of the hive and aren't able to produce as much honey out of that specific hive, although the other ones may catch up and make up for it. But so we are doing a few activities around the farm right now, like going through and cutting out some of the dead trees that we had even from back in the previous winter. The trees, a lot of times when they're under heavy stress from a cold winter, when they come into the spring, they'll start growing and they'll look healthy and they'll look fine. And then all of a sudden they get under a stress condition, either heat or heavy rains or wet conditions, whatever it may be, and the tree will all of a sudden just collapse. It'll just die. And most of that was not due to the conditions that happened at the moment. It was something that started way back in the winter. So we're going through and trying to trim out some of those trees. Most of those trees are old trees that we've had here on the farm from day one, and they're at about 25, 26 years old. On a grafted tree, much like these are grafted here, most of those live about 25, 30 years. So they're really starting to hit the end of their life cycle. And once that happens, then they start running all kinds of problems, issues, concerns, they start falling apart. So we're starting to run into that. And some of those trees, when they get in these cold temps and conditions, just can't handle it. So we're going through right now, we're trimming out a lot of those trees, cutting out dead branches, and we're chipping and getting rid of the material and trying to get it out of the orchard, because a lot of times it carries disease or other problems or issues that we don't want to spread to the other trees. And if the tree collapses, normally it is due to disease that causes it to collapse from that stress, and that's the stressor that finally does it in. So we want to try to remove that material, get it out of the orchard. So that's one of the activities that we're doing. One of the other activities that we're doing is working on our cover crop program through the orchard and through the rest of the farm. We go through and plant cover crops to help build the soil and also to help feed our pollinators and bees, which is a really important role of the crop, and then also to help with weed pressure. So it actually keeps some of the weeds at bay. Normally it takes a couple crop cycles to really eradicate a lot of the weed pressure, but it does help. Every time you're planting, you're trying to keep that pressure on those weeds so that they don't have a chance to germinate and spread and create havoc. So we're going through and dealing with some of the cover crops. Some is starting to mature at this point, and then other ones are starting to get prepped to go in. We needed some dry conditions to get them in, and we're starting to have that right now. So we're hoping in the next 3-4 days we're going to be working on that. The other thing that we're also going to be working on this next probably 2-3 days is hay. We cut normally about anywhere from 6 to 10 acres of hay. Approximately, it's not a lot, but just trying to get the right weather conditions to do it. You need a 3-day period of dry weather with our equipment that we operate. It needs about a 3-day period. So you need 3 days of sun, 70 to 80 degree weather, dry conditions, dry ground, which has been really hard to get. So we actually had about 2 or 3 acres cut a while back, and we've been waiting patiently to be able to get the right weather conditions to do the rest of it. And it looks like we're going to get a window to do that. So we have enough animals on the farm year round that we need to have a hay supply year round to feed them. So we cut enough to meet our need, and usually don't cut a whole lot more than that. So that's one of the activities that's coming up here on the farm. We are going to be going through. We've gotten some of our pumpkins in the ground a few weeks back, and we've just been waiting to cultivate and weed and deal with some of the other work there that we need to do with fertilizing and weeding, and we haven't had the conditions to do it. So we're waiting until those conditions hit, and it looks like now we're starting to get some sunshine, some dry weather, we'll be able to get out there and get some of that done. So we have some few things going on right now. We're starting to focus mainly on trying to get a lot of our crop work tidied up, I guess is the best way to put it. We only have a window to do it up until late July, because once we hit late July, then we transition into getting our buildings and facilities ready for the season, because we open up August 16th this year. So we only have a period of time of about 3 weeks to really get all the buildings checked through, all the machinery up and going, and everything prepped and ready. So we can start doing our packing and washing and a lot of those activities for the crop. So we try to get everything in the orchard buttoned up in this next 2 weeks or so, and then focus completely on buildings and maintenance and landscaping and some of those things that we have to get ready for the season. So that's what's going on the farm right now. If you have any questions, feel free to ask, and we'll hopefully be able to answer them for you. If you're wondering, you know, well, what about you know, conditions on the apples, on timing of, you know, when they're going to be ready or those type of things, we'll try to give you information on that if we can. But just wanted to give you a quick update on how things are going and what's going on here at the farm. And hopefully you learn a little bit about what we're doing right now.